Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to another video on LEGO Worlds. Damn, that's a pretty good rhyme. Maybe I should be some kind of a bad internet rapper. No. Let's don't do this. Bad internet rappers are plenty out there, so I don't think we need another one. Anyway, today we want to build the Inferno Tower. Designer/gamer made a live stream on building this in Bricksburg. A link to his channel is in the description. He is one of my favorite YouTubers out there. So make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you don't have it already. Anyway, today we are building this tower. I think it's better to make a video on how to construct it, because it gets kinda tricky on the top parts, and I thought doing some kind of instruction to build this is a little bit better than just putting it out there and let you figure out how to do it. Anyway, let's get started. We first start off with the base element. Let's go to free build and type in the prefix, which is infern, because the weird typing glitch won't let me type inferno, so it's infern. But I think that's enough. So we're building the furnished variant. There are also unfurnished modules out there, so you can build your own interiors, but we're going with the furnished variant because it's basically the same to construct. So we start with the base and just stick it somewhere here, maybe. Yeah, that's nice. And now we continue. I think, yeah, let's do the fusion lab, which is a mid A element. You can see it right there on the screen. So basically you start with the base and continue with the mid elements, like this one. So select it and make sure to line up the elevator. This is the easiest way to make sure everything is lined up correctly, especially for the middle parts. So take a look at the elevator. I think that looks good. And make sure, whoops, no, that's not what I wanted to do. Switch to build. And make sure this one, this part here, is lined up like this. So you have no bricks sticking out here. And so you can make sure everything is lined up correctly. Okay, but let's continue with the next element. For the next part, we're using a B element. I think we're going with the office. You can see it says mid B. And just stick it on top in the same way. Make sure everything lines up and place it. Yeah, that looks good. No bricks are sticking out on the elevator. That's nice. And now we take another A element of the mid modules, I think. Yeah, let's go with the laser lab. Okay, it's exactly the same. Just put it on the elevator and make sure everything is lined up. Oh, now you can see we got it wrong a little bit. As you can see, over here are some bricks sticking out on the lower part. So let's undo this and try it again. Okay. Oh, come on. It's some kind of hard to line this up because the pivot is in the middle of the element, and it would be kinda easier if the pivot was at the elevator, but we can't change that, unfortunately. So we have to do some trial and error. Yeah, but that looks good. No bricks are sticking out on the elevator. And now we can continue with another mid-B element. Yeah, let's put the RoboLab so we have each of the floors once in this building. Okay, line this up again. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, and now for the tricky part. Now we're getting to the top floors, which are kinda hard to line up correctly. Let's see, we start with the top A1 and continue with the top A2 and finish with the top A3 elements. Okay, let's start with the top A1 and stick it on the elevator again. This is a little bit harder because we have this outer construction on the tower with some neons. And yeah, that blocks our sight on the tower a little bit. But if you view it from the lower side, it's a little bit easier, so you can see if everything is lined up correctly. And yeah, that looks good. So again, make sure no brick is sticking out over here at the outer part of the elevator. Okay, yeah, but that looks pretty good. And I think we can continue with the top A2 element, like this one. As I said, we're going with the furnished variants, so we don't have to worry about furnishing it later. So this one is the hardest part of the tower, I think, and even I get it wrong most of the times, because it's a little bit wider than the lower parts and there's no elevator to line it up correctly, so you have to do some try and error again. Important is we have on this side two studs sticking out and on this side three studs sticking out, if I remember correctly, and on this side again two studs sticking out of the tower. And if I remember correctly, this should fit like this. As, again, take a look on the downside of this element and make sure everything looks like this. Yeah, remember this position? Two studs on this side and three studs on this side. And again, two studs on this side. So if you do it like this, it should fit. Oh, yeah, and of course remember to turn off, how do you call it in English? Overlap, yeah. Remember to turn off overlap. This is important. Otherwise you get results like this. And this looks pretty bad. So, okay, after you placed it, it's recommended to switch to build mode and take a look on the inside of the elevator. If everything inside the elevator is lined up, this element is placed correctly. But that looks good. No bricks are sticking out of the on the inside of the elevator. So I think we continue. As you can see, everything is lined up correctly. We have no bricks sticking out like this. And yeah, let's continue. The next part is a little bit tricky too, because this time we have again no elevator to line it up. But we have the staircase. And if this staircase is lined up correctly, the element is placed correctly. So let's continue with the top A3. Again, the furnished variant. Of course, you can use the unfurnished element if you want to build your own office for Dr. Inferno, because this is the top office part where Dr. Inferno figures out his evil plans to take over the world or whatever Dr. Inferno does. Yeah, as I said, make sure the staircase is lined up correctly. You can zoom in a little bit and take a look at this one. This is kinda hard, because yeah, the camera is a little bit wobbly and not very accurate. So let's just place it. And after you placed it, make sure the staircase doesn't stick out on any side. As you can see, everything is lined up, like this railing. This railing has to be on the same position like these bricks down here. And if that is the case, everything is placed correctly. So it looks like I got it right on the first try, which is quite kind of nice. So I think we can continue. And of course, after we have done that, I'll give you a quick tour of the tower and explain a little bit about the background story, so you know what everything is, or actually what everything is supposed to be. But let's finish the roof, because it's a little bit empty with this ICBM module. These are some rockets Dr. Inferno can fire when he's fed up with the agents or whatever enemies he has. So just place it down, make sure everything is lined up correctly, and this looks pretty good. So, okay, yeah, that was the Inferno Tower, at least the construction manual. Let's have a quick look around. Everything looks good. And oh yeah, before I forget it, there are some decoration elements like the Inferno Tower logo. And we want this, of course, to look like this. So the Robo Lab element has some shutters, so the glowing parts don't shine into it too much. Otherwise, you'll probably get blind from just working there. And we don't want Dr. Inferno's scientists to go blind. And this is why these shutters are on this side, which enables us to simply put this over here. Make sure it doesn't cover the window, because that would look kinda stupid. And now we got enough room to place the Evil Inc. logo down here. Make sure it is centered, but I think that looks good. And just stick it somewhere on the outside. Of course, you can place it somewhere else, but this is the best position to place the logo and the Evil Inc. logo. So, yeah, as I said, now we are really done with the tower, at least the construction, and now let's have a quick tour. But first, I think I'm gonna make a quick cut over here. Okay, yeah, let's continue with the tour. As you can see, it's getting dark because I had to make a quick cut. Let's switch to the Sky Spinner and make it day again. Oh, it was already night, so this took me longer than I expected, obviously. Yeah, but anyway, let's start our tour. Let's switch to first person so we can see better. Yeah, on the bottom level we got this nice evil looking lobby with the huge Dr. Inferno logo. Here you can make appointments with Dr. Inferno. As DSG said very accurate in his live stream on the Inferno Tower. Over here we got some file cases where files are stored. I don't know what evil corporations have to store, but there are some files in there. Over here we got the Coffee Master 5K. This is the most advanced coffee machine in LEGO Worlds. It makes you coffee so strong you can't drink more than one, otherwise you maybe get some cardiac arrest or something. So I won't recommend drinking too much of this coffee. Yeah. Unfortunately, I was too lazy to build stairs all the way up, because that would be a ridiculous amount of work. Actually, this tower was a ridiculous amount of work, and I don't know how I managed to get the motivation to build all this, but it was kind of fun to build, so it didn't felt like an eternity of building. Yeah, as I said, no stairs, so we have to climb up the elevator shaft, but that's no problem. So let's go up to the first floor. Yeah, here we got a little terrace, so you can see the surrounding and chill out a little bit, because even evil henchmen need some free time sometimes and some fresh air, because they have to stay healthy, regardless if they are evil or not. They're humans after all, or brick people, or Lego people, I don't know how to call them. Yeah, anyway, over here we got this conference room, where Dr. Inferno can meet up with his minions and give them instructions. Yeah, we have a nice little big TV over here for presentations and stuff like that. Yeah, because even doing evil stuff is a lot of bureaucracy, and yeah, you have to organize all of this, because doing evil isn't easy and requires a lot of effort. Yeah, anyway, let's go up to the next floor, because this one is kind of boring, I think. And the next one is way more interesting. Yeah, over here we got the fusion lab. This is where Dr. Inferno tinkers with his experimental fusion generator. In case you're wondering what a fusion generator is, basically a fusion generator emulates the chemical reaction that happens in our sun, in our solar system. And yeah, it instead of blasting some atoms, it fuses them together with some kind of a helium reaction, if I remember correctly. I'm not an expert on this topic, but yeah, basically what this is supposed to be, in here we got a nice looking glowing ball of helium from the fusion reaction. Don't get too close because it's kinda hot. I won't demonstrate it yet because walking in there will get you stuck in the top and I don't want to skydive yet. Anyway, just go. Don't go in there. It's bad time and you don't want that. Because I think walking in the sun isn't a good idea either. Yeah, as I said, this is basically a micro sun held in this magnetic field, so it touches nothing, because this stuff gets kinda hot. And yeah, here we got a little control console to change the parameters of the generator, and some more monitors, just because they look cool, in my opinion at least, and some lockers where you can store your clothes or equipment or something else. A nice little table for experimenting with the stuff that floats there, even if that is kind of unrealistic, but anyway, it's Lego, so I don't care a lot about realism. And some servers just to do the ridiculous complicated calculations needed to use this generator. Yeah, that's the fusion lab. Oh, don't forget the Nuka-Cola Quantum over here. Yeah, this is stolen from Fallout 4 or the Fallout series, but I don't care about intellectual property. Nah, just kidding. Actually, I do care because I don't want to get sued. Yeah, so this is some glowing beverage, actually. No Nuka-Cola. Don't listen to me. Yeah, that's the fusion lab. I kinda like it, because of all the glowing stuff and everything that's going on here. I had some fun building this. Okay, but let's continue our tour with the next floor. And our next floor is the probably most boring part of this building, except for the meeting room down there. This is an office where Dr. Inferno's minions have to do all the bureaucracy stuff I mentioned earlier. Yeah, it's kind of a depressing workspace with small cubicles. But I think the big windows make it a little bit better. Over here we got another coffee master and some trash bin. Yeah, but I think a depressing workspace is kind of fitting for Dr. Inferno's tower, because he's evil. He's just evil and he don't care as much about his minions, because he's an evil guy. Yeah, let's go up here. Over here we got another conference room with a flip chart. And another TV for presentations. Yeah, it's basically the same like the other conference room, nothing special. Yeah, here can the minions meet up to discuss topics in a group. I don't know what kind of topics they discuss, because I'm not evil, at least I like to think so. Yeah, but anyway, each office needs a meeting room. Okay, let's go to the next floor. Oh yeah, this is one of my favorite floors again. Yeah, this is Dr. Inferno's laser lab. Here he builds his giant experimental laser cannon to wipe out any of his enemies. Maybe the agents, maybe someone else, I don't know. Yeah, it's basically a huge laser cannon. Nothing special. I don't think I have to explain much about how a laser cannon works. And yeah, it has this nice glowing copper part with the lightning sticking out. And of course, we have some detail over here, like this terminal, which is inspired by another game I don't want to mention yet because of intellectual property. Nah, just kidding, it's a recreation from the Fallout series. Yeah, to make this look a little bit nicer, we got some modern art here. A toolbox and this workstation, workbench with another cola and some batteries. Of course, we got some servers here because every laser cannon needs some kind of control and some screens. Oh, and here we have the laser rifle from the Fallout series. I don't think if it's clear that this is a laser rifle, that's why I'm mentioning that. And yeah, of course, we got all kinds of decoration like these used fuel cells for the laser cannon, some cables sticking out, going to the servers. Yeah, and that's basically it about the laser lab. Oh yeah, and of course, we got this giant door so we can stick out the laser cannon and shoot at stuff like this huge tree down there. Unfortunately, it doesn't work because, as I said, it's experimental and it's not quite done yet. Dr. Inferno has to tinker a little bit more to make it work. Yeah, I think that's all about this floor. So let's continue our tour to the next floor. Oh yeah, the next floor I like a lot. This is a RoboLab. Where Dr. Inferno and his minions develop new drones and robots to spread mayhem across the world. Like this drone, which has a small cannon. Over here you can see the targets. This one is already blasted by the drone. So maybe we can get some useful data on how to improve this drone. Over here we got a little workbench with another Nuka-Cola Quantum, an unfinished robot arm, and this thing. No, this is no microscope. This is one of those small tracked camera robots the military uses to defuse bombs or explore dangerous areas. So Dr. Inferno managed to get his hands on one of them too. Yeah, just for experimenting. And yeah, what this thing does is actually drives around and has a small arm with a camera on top. So you can observe anything around you. Anyway, let's continue. Another coffee master because every worker needs coffee, and another workbench with a toolbox. And let's go up to the upper part. So as I said earlier, these are the shutters. Now you can see why they are here. Otherwise, we would have this giant logo, super bright, lighting the whole room, and that would look kind of stupid. So anyway, over here we got another robot that is kind of stolen from the Fallout series. This was a Mr. Handy. It's called Mr. Handy in the Fallout series. Dr. Inferno developed his own variant of the Mr. Handy series. It's called the Mr. Angry. As you can see, it has some angry eyebrows over his eyes. So to make sure it looks evil enough for Dr. Inferno. And over here we got this nice terminal to, yeah, basically program the robot. And some nice looking floodlights I included from another pack of mine. Oh, before I forget to mention it, of course you can download everything you see here from my BrickSafe page, but not everything is part of the Inferno Tower, especially the props. Of course, the whole building is part of the Inferno Tower pack, but not all props, like these floor mats. For example, these are part of my vault pack, and if you want to use them in your own builds, just download the vault pack. It includes also these nice looking modern lights and a lot of other stuff like the new Coca-Cola and is there something else here from my vault pack? I use this stuff kinda often. So it's, if you want to build similar stuff like me, just download the vault pack and you got lots of useful props. But anyway, that's not important for this video. I think mentioning it is worth it. Okay, sorry, I lost the concentration for a moment. Yeah, anyway, let's continue with our tour. Just download my vault pack, it's great. Let's go to the next floor. Oh, the next floor I like a lot, but it's getting dark again. This is Dr. Inferno's library and his chess room, I'd say. Here we got some paintings. They're quite expensive because Dr. Inferno is ridiculously rich. I don't know how he made his money, but being evil obviously pays off. Nah, just kidding, be a good person. But Dr. Evil managed to somehow get his money out of sources I don't know about. But anyway, of course we've got a little chess table here and some decoration like this one. This is inspired by a music video, but I can't remember the name right now. This is scenery from a music video I kind of stolen. Oh, yes, it was Post Malone, Rockstar. There we got, in this music video, we got this decorative, I don't know what to call it, it's a fish tank with trees in it, basically. It looks kinda Asian, that's why there are some bonsai trees over here. But I think it looks nice and gives a nice touch to the room. And obviously we got nice big windows, so you can look out at all of Dr. Inferno's world, because Dr. Inferno's opinion is everything belongs to him. That's why he wants to get world domination, but this is not important for the moment. Yeah, let's go to the next floor. I think the next floor is the final to climb the elevator shaft. Okay, yeah, here we got some nice paintings. Oh, this looks nearly like me. Yeah, this is supposed to look like me. I had no idea what to paint, so I thought I'd just do this one. Anyway, so let's continue. Over here we got a chill out area with a nice looking carpet and a pool table, some drinks. And through this door we got a nice looking landing platform with some missiles to rearm Dr. Inferno's evil vehicles, whatever that may be. And some toolboxes and some more ammo, a console and stuff like that. Nothing special, just a landing platform. Okay, let's go to the next floor. Oh, no. Dr. Inferno's favorite hobby is collecting old artifacts. Artifacts like this classic hourglass or this little golden pyramid, and he puts all of them in his private art collection, which is here and on the next floor. For example, Dr. Inferno has stolen this wall from a Sphinx in the desert biome. This is actually copied from the Sphinx. And yeah, Dr. Inferno likes Egyptian artifacts a lot. Like the top of this obelisk. Obviously, it's illegal to just chop that off and take it home. But Dr. Inferno doesn't care about this. And over here, we got this Pharaoh's mask. I think you have seen something like this a lot in books and media. This is basically a mask which with which a Pharaoh is buried with. They put them on his face so you don't see the ugly dead face and instead a nice looking golden mask. And yeah, Dr. Inferno just took it and put it in his home because it looks nice. It looks really nice. It's gold and blue and silver, and Dr. Inferno likes precious stuff. And yeah, over here we got a vase. Dr. Inferno, as I said, likes ancient stuff and took this vase too from some ruins. Yeah, over here we got a nice little chill out area again with some couches and drinks. But you probably won't chill out much here because you can see all the way down to the bottom floor. Oh god damn it, there are cats out here screaming. I don't know why, but obviously they are fighting. I don't know if you can hear that, probably not because it's kinda quiet. But there are some of the cats screaming out there. But anyway, let's continue. Let's go up here and welcome to Dr. Inferno's personal office. This is where Dr. Inferno conducts his daily business. He has a nice looking conference room again. Yeah, this one was supposed to be some kind of a world map, but I messed it up pretty bad. So you probably can't see what this is supposed to be. Yeah, but it's supposed to be a world map. With a little fantasy, maybe you can notice that it's some kind of a map. But anyway, there's something on the screen. Don't look too much at it. Yeah, over here we got Dr. Inferno's private desk with some nice red buttons. Maybe they are to launch some missiles on the roof, or to get rid of minions he don't like anymore. He doesn't like anymore. And of course he has this giant chair to make sure everybody knows he's the boss. Because obviously only supervillains have a chair like this. And yeah, of course every supervillain needs a tank with glowing jellyfish and a tank with a shark to feed his enemies too. And yeah, that's what you can see here. Some glowing jellyfish and a shark. And yeah, of course, Dr. Inferno likes himself a little bit too much and has a portrait of himself in his office. So everybody knows this is the big man. And obviously I'm not, because I'm Moimus and not Dr. Inferno. Okay, yeah, here we got some servers again because Dr. Inferno needs some computing power for his plans. And Dr. Inferno is a collector of guns and weapons. So he has a laser rifle over here on display, and this oversized sniper rifle I made a while ago, stored on these consoles. And yeah, that's basically the whole tower. Over here we got a nice looking mosaic on the floor with Dr. Inferno's logo. If you look closely, you can see the resemblance. I hope it's clear that this is Dr. Inferno's logo, but I think it's pretty obvious. Okay, yeah, that was our tour and building instruction of the Inferno Tower. As I said, you can download everything you see in this video from my Bricksafe page. And if you want to see some more video footage on the Inferno Tower, make sure to check out Designer/Gamer's YouTube page, because he has made a great video on the Inferno Tower too. And his other content is just ridiculously good. He makes Lego Worlds videos, and make sure to support him. Don't let this game die. Make sure to keep this game public, because it's a great game, and it's a shame the developers don't continue it. Because there's so much room for opportunities to improve this game. This could be the virtual showcase for the whole Lego collection. They could advertise every set they bring out in this game. And I don't know why they don't take this opportunity, because it's a great opportunity, it's a great business opportunity. But anyway, this is just my personal opinion, and probably they won't never continue on this game. But this is not a video about the game itself. This is just a video about the Inferno Tower and how to construct it. So I think we conclude the video here, and I wish you all a great day. If you haven't already liked and subscribed, please do me a favor and leave a like and subscribe. It helps out my channel really, really. And it keeps me motivated, because if I see people like my content, I'll produce more of it. One last thing, I'm sorry I haven't uploaded in a while now, because I'm busy making my own game. But you'll see some of that later when I've got something to show, because developing a game is obviously a huge job. But I don't want to go into detail about this, and just finish the video now. So have a nice day and goodbye.